Hello and welcome to the unit Hydrogen Production from Biological Methods. We will start with a short introduction about the different existing methods, followed by a description of the processes needed to obtain hydrogen from biomass and from other biological processes. The processes for obtaining hydrogen from biological methods can be classified in two types: thermochemical processes and biochemical processes, as we can see here in the figure. Generally, thermochemical processes are used in the production of hydrogen in large-scale centralized systems due to the manipulation of large quantities of biomass and the economy of scale required for this type of process. We can distinguish between gasification processes and pyrolysis processes. In contrast, biological processes are often used in the centralized system, being slower and more expensive than the thermochemical ones. Among these methods, we can find the dark fermentation, the photofermentation, and the biophotolysis. Let's start with the hydrogen production using biomass as the main source. Biomass is a renewable resource of organic origin and therefore with a hydrogen content to consider. Biomass can be found in different sources, which includes very heterogeneous materials such as forest and agricultural waste, municipal solid waste, livestock waste, and energy crops, among others. Biomass contains on average about 6% by weight of hydrogen, which is equal to 0.672 normal cubic meters of gaseous hydrogen produced from 1 kilogram of biomass. Although the energy efficiency of the transformation is high, the production of hydrogen from biomass is moderate due to its low hydrogen content, compared, for example, with the 25% of content that the biomass has. Among the advantages of using biomass, we can identify that it's a neutral CO2 process because emitted CO2 was previously absorbed by the plants. Using biomass also allows the development of developing countries when they have high quantities of biomass available, and the production of all types of solid fuel, liquid fuels such as biodiesel or bioethanol, or gaseous fuel such as biogas. Obtaining hydrogen from biomass is a thermochemical process, and we can differentiate mainly two methods: pyrolysis and gasification. Both processes, with the subsequent reforming of the liquid products obtained, are identical processes to those applied to fossil fuels. The main difference are due to the fact that the chemical composition of biomass is highly variable and that its CO2 emissions are not accounted for due to its short absorption cycle. The table here summarizes the efficiency of the different thermochemical processes of obtaining hydrogen from biomass, in any case, well below 90% efficiency of the natural gas reforming. We will explain now the two methods just mentioned to obtain hydrogen. The gasification process is an incomplete combustion reaction from which a mix of fuel gas of CO, CO2, hydrogen, and CH4 is obtained. It is an exothermic reaction, and the heat required for the gasification comes essentially from the partial oxidation of the fuel. The most commonly used gasifiers are fixed bed and fluidized bed. For the gasification of biomass using catalysts in fluidized bed, we need to operate at temperatures of about 650 degrees, while in fixed bed, they operate in the range between 600 and 800 degrees Celsius. The theoretical efficiency of biomass gasification process depends on the temperature present, amount of steam and oxygen used, and the optimum theoretical value is 54%. In order to improve the efficiency of this process, it is very interesting to capture CO2 at the same time as the gasification takes place, using, for example, calcium oxide. In this case, the concentration of hydrogen in the final gas obtained may increase by 20%. The autothermal gasification of the biomass in fluidized bed gives results to a synthesis gas formed approximately by the fraction that are represented in the pie graph. Here we have 30% of hydrogen, 30% of CO2, 30% of CO, between 5 and 10% of methane, and 3% of other heavy hydrocarbons. The second process is the pyrolysis, which consists on the decomposition of a solid fuel by the action of heat, normally about 450 degrees Celsius, and in the absence of an oxidizing medium. The end products can be gases, liquids or solids, where liquid fraction or bio-oils are the most promising products for the production of hydrogen through subsequent reforming processes. In experimental results and studies, a hydrogen production of 80% of the theoretical maximum values has been obtained. Besides, research is currently focused on the reforming state with catalysts with the aim of minimizing carbon formation in the catalyst. Moreover, autothermal reforming is getting a lot of attention from researchers as a combination of oxidation and steam reforming. Here, oxidation acts as an internal heat source that supplies thermal energy to the endothermic steam reforming process. In this way, an external heat supply is not necessary. In addition, the combination of this reaction can improve temperature control and hotspot formation, decreasing catalyst deactivation and carbon deposition. Currently, there are different challenges facing hydrogen production from biomass. The first one is that there is no fully developed technology yet. Although there are a number of biomass gasification demonstration plants in the world, the technology is not yet fully developed, and the problem of the formation of tars that may cause catalyst poisoning has not been fully resolved yet. In all cases, the produced gas will need to be further processed to extract hydrogen. In addition, the hydrogen content of biomass is very low, as we mentioned before, and this leads intrinsically to low conversion efficiencies. Biomass has the potential to accelerate the role of hydrogen in the future energy scenario. However, as long as production and especially transport costs remain at current levels, even with reasonable energy efficiency, hydrogen cannot be economically competitive with natural gas reforming. One option is to convert the biomass in situ into ethanol or bio-oils and transport these products to the reforming plants at relatively low cost because they are liquids. The greatest challenge is obtaining hydrogen by biomass is to reduce the cost of the equipment and the cost of supplying biomass. Finally, the complex processing of biomass means that it is generally a more expensive way of producing low-carbon hydrogen than solar or wind-based electrolysis. Combining hydrogen production from biomass with carbon capture and storage could, however, be an option to create the so-called negative emissions, which may have a role to play in the future. We will discuss now about the different biological processes to obtain hydrogen, which depends on the presence on an enzyme that produces hydrogen. These enzymes catalyze their chemical reaction shown in this equation. P hydrogenase enzymes are used in biophotolysis processes, while nitrogenous enzymes are used in photofermentation processes. Let's start by explaining the biophotolysis system. In this process, hydrogen is produced as a result of certain biological organisms using sunlight to store their energy in chemical form. In theory, two forms of production are distinguished. First, release of hydrogen from the photolytic decomposition of water, and secondly, extraction of the hydrogen stored in the biomass that serves as a nutrient of the microorganism. This process is drawn here in the figure. In the photosynthesis process, photosynthetic algae and bacteria absorb the energy from sunlight and they use it to separate water in the process of generating plant tissue. Hydrogen production appears to be a prior state of anaerobic microorganism before fixing hydrogen with carbon when consuming CO2. When green algae sensitive to visible light and photosynthetic bacteria sensitive to infrared light are put in a photoreactor, they produce hydrogen and sugars that add feed to the fermenter. This last element is an anaerobic digester that contains another type of bacteria which produce the fermentation of the sugars and the biomass feed from the outside. As a product of this fermentation, hydrogen is produced, as well as other effluents which are sent back to the photoreactor. The solar efficiency of conversion of green algae is 10%, whereas of the photosynthetic bacteria is 6%. The commercialization of photosynthetic processes requires a drastic increase in conversion efficiency, as well as an improvement in microorganisms. The photofermentation is the transformation of organic matter into hydrogen by purple bacteria and microalgae through a series of enzymes. It only happens in the presence of light, and if microalgae are used, one of the methods to obtain hydrogen is to deprive the algae of sulfides so that the algae begins to generate hydrogen instead of the oxygen it would generate through photosynthesis. Production rates go up to 800-900 millimole hour per meter. The general hydrogen production reaction can be expressed as shown in this equation. To conclude this unit, we will explain now what is the dark fermentation. Anaerobic bacteria can produce hydrogen growing in the dark and on a substrate rich in carbohydrates. Here, hydrogen production is carried out by the anaerobic metabolisms of pyruvate. Production rates in this case go up to 77 millimol per hour per liter. There are two working modes: the mesophilic mode at around 35 degrees Celsius or the thermophilic mode at around 55 degrees Celsius. As advantages of these methods, we can find that high production rates can be obtained in terms of reactor volume, no light is required in this method, different substrates can be used, and the reactor used are very easy to handle. Thank you for your attention.